Hey guys, welcome back to the Car Couple channel. We are done with our final round of the Corona Car Challenge. I first just wanted to thank everybody for sticking along with us through this month-long thing. Thank you so much for all the pictures that you sent us. I definitely enjoyed looking at all of them through all the different topics. But for this video, we are going to go over the winners of the final round, which was our wild card challenge.
Yeah guys, with the wild card challenge, we wanted you guys to feel as free as you could, have some fun with the photos. Your job was just to submit the best photo that you could of your car. No rules, no fancy applause, no extra goal that you had to make it happen. We wanted to see what your cars could do and how much fun you guys could have with it. So big thanks to everybody who participated. And we really appreciate, just like Felicia said, everybody that took time to do these things with us. We hope we kept you guys a little bit busy through the whole quarantine and everything like that.
All right, so without further ado, we wanted to actually announce a couple of, more than just the top three, because there were some really good pictures, and just to, you know, give a little shout out to them. So the first one was G35 Duddy Boy. He sent a couple pictures that we really liked. This one, I think you liked the best with the front end.
Yeah, I like the car specifically because, I mean, he's got his tag on it right at the bottom. Anyway, you can see it right at the front of the bumper. He sent us the build sheet of it as well, and there's a lot of work that's gone into the cosmetics of this car. So I really like to see what people are doing specifically when they're trying to put their own spin on the car. Mm-hmm. So even though you didn't take the top spot, we definitely wanted to put this car up because we can tell that you've done some serious work to it on your time, and we really appreciate you submitting stuff to us. And this wasn't the first thing that you submitted. Actually, you won a prize from us earlier in one of the earlier rounds, so we really appreciate you putting that extra time in there, and we wanted to make sure we gave you a little bit of shine in the video. That takes us into the next person, Mr. Jose Nismo 13. Now, what I like about this shot here is he does a really good job of using the backgrounds and stuff when he shoots pictures. We've gotten pictures from him in almost every round, and he really does a good job of playing with both camera angles, car position, lighting. You can tell he's got the mind of a photographer. I really like seeing the way he kind of plays around with the Subaru when he shoots it. So that's my take on it.
Yeah, I mean, I really like the color contrast too with the greenery and the blue car. Like, both the colors really stand out. And I don't know if it's his camera, but the edits that he does with the pictures really brings out those colors.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah. So into the third spot for the challenge, Cam Van Dahe. He sent us a roller that looks really nice. I know rollers are super hard to do. I still have yet to do one with my car.
Rollers are definitely tough to shoot. You gotta have your camera set perfectly to get it the way you want. If you open it up too much, you end up with blurry shots. If your timing of it isn't well, then the background gets really distorted and doesn't help you.
Well, so even getting like a street like without cars in the way, or having to slow down, speed up, like, I think that's really difficult to put all those things together.
Yeah, and I really like his car. He has this purple and like royal blue chameleon paint job that he's been playing around with his cars. He sent us a couple of shots. I really have grown to like what he's been able to do with it. I really wish he had submitted a picture when he did the when we did the background challenge for trying to get your car camouflaged. He actually messaged us and said there was no way he could find a way to get that picture in there. So I'm really glad that he was able to submit some stuff on the last round. And the thing I actually like is if you look close, you can see that he's able to still show what his wheels look like, even though it's a rolling shot. Like, if I zoom in right here on these wheels, you can still see the outline of what the wheels actually look like.
With the spokes, yeah.
Yep. So, I mean, that's definitely really dope. On to the number two spot. On the number two spot, we have a guy who's actually pretty close to us. This was shot over in King of Prussia. Mr. Kind of Quick G37 with a night shot of his car. I love the way he's playing with the lights and stuff in the background. You can see his marker lights are on just to kind of bring the focus into his car a little bit. But perfect pose, good edits. I can't really tell how much he's done with like filtering and everything, but the picture itself definitely looks really, really good. obviously you can't get a ton of detail out of the car itself because it's a night shot, but from what I can see, the car looks really good. I've seen this car in a bunch of other things that he's done, and I know how nice the car really looks, so he's definitely posing the car really nicely.
Well, and I know that we mentioned in one of the other videos that actually getting a good night shot is challenging itself, so you can still see details in it, and the different lights in the background, I don't know. I like night shots because nightlife is just a different thing in itself, so getting the different lights without them like being over saturating on the photos is really nice.
No doubt.
All right, and now on to number one spot.
Felicia's pretty happy about
this. I'm super happy about this. The video, I mean, obviously it's a 350Z, but the picture that he sent was amazing. So Sonali, Nick, I believe is his name, sent us this shot. And it is, I mean, I really like it.
Right.
With the smoke, and he did send us another picture in a previous challenge.
He won the camouflage challenge.
Yeah, obviously, because this car's camo.
Yeah. He won the camouflage challenge, and it looks really good. I mean, you still have the bikes in the background, but I mean, the car is posed perfectly for the shot, and obviously a smoke background and everything makes it look really good. We got a couple from him, and this is definitely the best one that he sent us. I like the 350Z in general. Just like, I actually went and did a little bit of looking behind to see what the cars had done to it, and it's an impressive car. And I mean, it's cool to be able to put together like a little, what is that? Yeah, like it's fully digital, but at the same time, it's not like over the top. Like, at first I thought he had like eyelids on it to kind of match, but it's actually, like the headlights kind of blend in, the headlights kind of blend into the camo.
I mean, this reminds me, we need to do some smoke shots too.
We do.
Because it looks super dope.
Yeah.
I like it.
But again, guys, thanks to everybody who submitted stuff. We really appreciate it. And we are going to get promo codes and stuff out to everybody who took the top spots. We might even throw a few things to some other people if you're lucky and if Felicia's feeling generous.
It was you originally said it.
But as always, guys, we really appreciate it. We really appreciate everybody taking the time to have some fun with us. And hopefully we brought a little bit of a bright side to your quarantine stuff going on. With that being said, as always, my name is Will. This is Felicia.
Check us out on the Instagram.
You can submit stuff to us. We always, with all the videos we do, we don't mind answering questions and doing little how-tos and things. So if there's ever any questions you guys have that you want to see featured in a video, you can DM us at carcouple_ZG. And with that, I will see you guys, as will she, in the next one.